Hello everyone, welcome to my classroom. Today, I'll continue the tutorial about the CodeIgniter 4. CodeIgniter is an open source software rapid development web framework for use in building dynamic websites with PHP. In this video, we'll learn the CRUD operation example and use. For now, I'll only show how to make a create and read operation. I'll make the tutorial of update and delete operation in the next video as soon as possible. For your information, in this video, I'll also show you a little example of form validation use. Okay, if you have ready, close the door and let's begin. Before we start, please make sure your database is ready. Here's my table structure. You can use your table or use the same table in this video. There's no problem and not make any difference. I don't have the view of this menu now. So, I'll make the view for the table that will display on this menu first. If you already have it, you don't need to follow this step. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to make a read function of CRUD first. Some table rows will display in this view. I'll make a create function after these have finished. If you follow this step, create a new folder and file for the main view of the menu. Give the name as you want. If you're using Bootstrap like me, you can copy the elements from the Bootstrap page and make some changes. I want to display only some columns. The rest will not display. In this case, the view will show only a title, status, date create, and the publish date column. If finished, let's make the controller in the method. Open the controller folder and create a new file. The class name must be the same as the controller file. In this controller, we'll call the form and the date helper. I use the constructor to call the helper. Why do I load the date helper? It's because I'll set the time zone to match my countries. To set the time zone, open your app file. You'll find these here. By using this way, you don't need to set the time zone in your controller. Now, let's make the method that we'll call the page. In this method, I'll load the model and make it load the items in my database table. Load the model first. I'll create the model later. Add this line to run the method from the model. Don't forget to load your page view. Now, let's make the model. The table will be loaded in this model. Choose your table by using this line that used to specify the primary database table that works with this model. Set the primary key for this table. All models must have a primary key specified to allow all of the features to work as expected. Set your allowed fields. This array should be the same as the field names. Only the fields in this array that allowed to use. Now query all the table items. I want to use the findAll query. By using this query, the method will return all results. I want to sort all results by the last date created the article. We can modify the query by adding the order by clause. The first parameter contains the name of the column. The second parameter lets you set the direction of the result. We have some options here, like ascending, descending, and random. The view is ready now. Now, let's display the query. Just follow this step. First, I'll use the looping to display the number. After that, use the for each loop to display all the query's results. Now open the browser and refresh the page. Let's see the result. I got an error here. I forget to load the data view in my controller. Nothing here, the table just had blank fields. No problem, because indeed I don't have anything for this table now. But that indicates the read operation is have run. Now, let's make the create operation. The same as before, we need to make the method in view first. You don't need to make the new controller. Create a new file for the view. This view will contain the input form. Use the form open to create an opening form tag with a base URL built from your config preferences. The parameter that I have defines a form action or targetary string. It means the form will be managed by the create method within the article controller. In this way, we can let the action attribute of the form keep blank. Use the setValue function to permit you to set the value of an input form or text area. Use the field name as the parameter. I use this function to keep the value of the input field when the form got an error. I want to make the date field fills automatically, so I add a hidden input for the date created input form. Use the date function. The parameters of this function are the format of the date. Now let's make the method to load the view. If finished, refresh the browser and open the page that has created. As you can see, we have the form now. I'll make a little change to the text area. The form is ready, but we cannot use it at the moment yet. As you know, we use the form open, and we have the parameter as a array target that will manage all of the input fields. So, let's make the method. I want to make all the input form marked as a required input field. If so that, then I need a form validation to validate all of the input. To run the form validation, be sure you load the form validation library first. Add this line to load the library. Load the model. Open the validation file within the app folder. After that, set the form validation rules. If finished, go back to your application controller and give a condition to run this method. I want to display errors message when the forms are not valid. By default, the errors do not have a style. I use the bootstrap alert to styling the error messages. Use the listError function to display all error messages. Add a new method from the model. Add this line to redirect the page when the validation is true. Open the model and create a new method. All done. Let's try the CRUD operation that we have. I'll keep the fields blank to see the validation has worked. Look, the error message appears here. It's cool, the validation has worked so well. I think all is work well. Try to add something into the input form. Save and see what happens. As you can see, the data has been inserted to the table now. I only had a little bug here. The numbers are not displayed. Do a change to fix this. Okay, that's a basics example of create and read operation use in CodeIgniter 4. I hope you could be understood all the defines that I said at this video. You can find the full source code of these examples on our GitHub. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.